In this example, we are required to find the magnetic induction vector at origin due to the current carrying wire configuration which we can see in the figure. So, your magnetic induction at origin will be due to different wire segments. Here we can see due to the wire segment BC and DE, there will not be any magnetic induction at O because point O is lying along the line of these wire segments. So, magnetic induction at O can be written as magnetic induction due to the wire segment AB and plus magnetic induction due to the wire segment CD and plus magnetic induction due to the wire segment EF, which is a quarter circular arc, and then magnetic induction due to the wire segment FG. So, there will be in total 4 terms vector sum of which will give the total magnetic induction at point O. Now, we just have a look on the wire segment AB. It is a semi-infinite wire located at a distance A, perpendicular distance A from one end of the wire from the origin. So, magnetic induction direct result we can write as mu naught I by 4 pi A. And as the wire is lying in XY plane, its magnetic induction must be in Z direction. So, here by right hand thumb rule we can see it is along minus z direction. So, we can multiply the unit vector minus k cap here. Plus, if we talk about the magnetic induction due to the wire segment CD, it is located at a distance, this total distance is 2a. So, this distance will be 2a cos 45, that is root 2a distance from origin. Now, due to this wire, wish to find out magnetic induction at origin, we make use of the result of a finite wire, which is mu naught I by 4 pi root 2a multiplied by cos 45 plus cos 45, which is root 2. And as the wire lies in XY plane, its magnetic induction is along Z direction, and by using right hand thumb rule, we can see it is along minus Z direction. So, we multiply it with the minus k cap. Thus, if we talk about the magnetic induction due to the quarter circular wire segment EF, the magnetic induction will be mu naught I by 8A because it is 1/4 of that of a circular coil in which a current I is flowing. Now, in this situation, we can see if a current I is flowing everywhere, due to the segment EF which lies in XZ plane, its magnetic induction must be along Y direction, and by right hand thumb rule we can say it is along minus J cap direction. Plus the last term will be the wire FG, which is again a semi-infinite wire located at a distance A, so its magnetic induction will be mu naught I by 4 pi A, and we talk about its plane, it is the YZ plane, and by right hand thumb rule its magnetic induction is along plus X direction, so we'll multiply it with the unit vector plus I cap. If we just simplify this result, here you can see this root 2 gets cancelled out. Here mu naught I by 4 pi A we can take common, and inside the bracket we can write one as I cap, then here you can see we have taken pi common, so in this situation we'll use minus pi by 2 j cap and minus 2 k cap. That will be the answer to this problem.